This is City TV, everywhere.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year, Toronto! All the best to you in 1991.
Tuesday, January 1st, the day after a safe New Year's Eve, and more Canadian troops on their way to the Gulf. Good evening. It was one of the quietest, safest, and crime-free New Year's Eve on record. The largest party at Nathan Phillips Square went off without a hitch. Lara DiBattista has more.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Happy New Year, Toronto!
Despite a wind chill temperature of around minus 19 degrees last night, between 20 and 30,000 people packed Nathan Phillips Square to usher in the new year. Hundreds of extra officers were called in case things got rowdy, but the police spent most of the time just standing around enjoying the party.
There weren't too many arrests. About 53 people were treated by ambulance crew for various illnesses, most of them alcohol-related. A few people were taken into 52 Division and 55 Division for various charges. Most were dealing with intoxicated.
So just basically people having a good time then?
Yeah, from all intents, it appears that way.
Besides the few incidents of drunkenness, police say the crowd at Nathan Phillips Square last night was extremely well-behaved. About the most serious incident they report is a broken window at Simpsons.
Other store windows were left alone as the revelers dispersed along Yonge Street.
Once the concert was over at Nathan Phillips Square, the traffic officers were in the intersection to ensure the safety of the citizens. And as you can see from the street at the present time, we've had a very, very pleasant and excellent evening for all of us.
But not everyone was pleased the streets were so quiet last night. Cab drivers say they were desperate for fares.
There was no people to pick up. No business.
Pretty quiet?
Terrible. The worst year I've ever seen.
How long you been driving cab?
About 26 years.
And that was the worst night you've ever seen?
Worst I've ever seen for New Year's Eve.
Judging from the number of champagne corks littering Nathan Phillips Square today, not exactly everyone had a quiet, sedate New Year's Eve. But for the third year in a row, the party here has gone without a hitch. And that's a great way to start off the new year. From Nathan Phillips Square, I'm Lara DiBattista for City Pulse.
And what goes up must come down. Last night's City Hall celebration, just a memory now. Crews busy today putting things back in place and thinking about next year. And there was the traditional party at City Hall today, the annual New Year's Day Mayor's Levy.
Today we've had 2,000 people come to this levee at City Hall. It's an opportunity to come and meet not only the members of City Council, but to also enjoy some of the hospitality here on the foyer of City Hall. Coffee, donuts, a great afternoon.
All right.
While the turnout was large, local politicos missed, or at any rate claimed they missed, one familiar face. Our own intrepid political specialist, Colin Vaughn.
Hi. Oh, look, they even got her a little hat. She's got a dress on and everything.
Only 18 hours old and already one of the most famous faces in Canada, little Maria Andriadis, 6 pounds, 12 ounces, was born 1 second after midnight at Toronto East General.
You see the baby? Don't smile a little bit in the camera.
We're delighted to welcome the new baby, Andriadis, here to Toronto East General. She's the first baby born at Toronto East General today, born 1 second after midnight. And that's quite a record, actually. I don't know that you could get a lot closer than that.
What's happening?
Maria shares the honor of being the first baby of 1991 with a girl born in Slave Lake, Alberta.
The reason why I'm optimistic about the new year is because, well, I seem to be a person that likes to think positively about things, life in particular.
No, actually, I'm not. I'm usually an optimistic person, but there's just so much confusion about the GST and I'm just worried about like what's going on in Iraq.
Personally, I'm optimistic, I think, about myself and my own life and my family, but at the moment it's hard to be optimistic about my beloved country and the Middle East situation, which is terrifying.
I'm not. Last year I was, economically and politically, but this year things have taken a downturn, so good luck, Toronto.
Nationwide today, there's a mood of pessimism. A Gallup survey concludes Canadians have the bleakest outlook for a new year since it began polling. 63% of those asked believe that 1991 will be worse than 1990. Of major concern to Canadians this New Year's Day, the GST, and how will the economy cope? Hundreds of calls continue to come into the GST areas. Info lines, they're open despite the holiday. Tomorrow, the effect will be felt at the LCBO stores. They will not be open until noon, and Eaton's closed all day today while staff change price tags. What if you were out shopping today? Videographer Dominic Shulo tested the GST waters.
Can I get one coffee, please?
Sure. Colombian?
Yeah, that'll do.
Okay.
So how much is that costing me?
$1.10.
What would it cost me yesterday?
$1.05. Yeah.
So I'm paying an extra nickel for my coffee.
Yes, you are. Yes, you are. And a lot of the customers this morning have not been very happy about it.
I feel terrible about it. I think it's outrageous. I really do. I resent it very, very much, but there's nothing I can do about it.
With my 7% extra coffee, I'm now off to get some gas.
So, Mike, how much extra is gas going to cost me today?
No extra. No one gas station I check around, they don't change the price, and so we don't change too. Nobody from the office called me about change the price, so the price still the same.
Like yesterday. But propane has gone up?
Yes, propane has gone up.
How do you feel about paying more for your propane today?
Well, like everything else is going up. Yeah, what can you do?
Sanitary napkins, there are some that really is taxable and some is not. And the reason I don't know yet, probably I have to learn more about it.
Only one is not taxed, right?
There is only one, or some baby diapers are taxable, some are not.
What were you complaining about?
About the confusion that exists on various products having to do with the GST. And of course, the store owners are finding it every bit as confusing as the customers.
So you figure you want to avoid all this, just go rent a movie, go home and relax. Well, too bad. These are also taxed. And once you do get home and you require more information, call the GST Consumer Information Hotline at this number. And don't forget, pay phones are also taxed. Dominic Shulo, City Pulse.